السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ شبہات کا ازالہ پیج کو سبسکرائب کریں اور بیل آئیکن دبائیں سب سے پہلے ویڈیو دیکھنے کے لیے۔
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم۔ لیٹر آف مولانا یوسف رحمۃ اللہ علیہ ریگارڈنگ ایفرٹ ان رمضان وتھ ریوائزڈ ٹرانسلیشن۔ Introduction: We hope from Allah Rabbul Izzat that you are doing well and that you are busy and focused in the high effort of da'wat. Especially in this blessed month, it is the best chance to make this effort. In this month, Allah's special mercy is attentive towards us. Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullahi Alayhi wrote a letter about the effort in Ramadan and we are presenting it to you so that the responsible brothers may read this to the audience in the Markaz and can give encouragement to practice upon these points. Dearest honorable and respectable brothers, it is a great favor and blessings and ease from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that as conditions to practice the deen become more difficult, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making it a little easier for us to practice deen. Today our condition is that although this life of dunya is very temporary, the trend has become that we are spending our life and wealth only for this life of dunya. In such a time, it is a great favor that Allah directed us to a great method of effort, gasht and sacrifices. When we not only senior responsible old workers but all the entire Muslim Ummah in general give value to the gasht and sacrifice and submit a small amount of our time and wealth for its sake, we can be hopefully to see the doors of Hidayah opening generally upon everybody on the face of the earth. My dear respectable brothers, to obtain the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and success in both the worlds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us complete deen. The complete deen is connected to every aspect of our life. Now, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we are guided, we can bring this convictions to our hearts that the only one who sustains us and changes the condition and circumstances of the world is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Also, the benefits we get from using the asbab, everything we see as far as shapes, configurations of the world in different shapes and configurations, this benefit is also from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can benefit us through His will, through these asbab, means and worldly shapes, configurations. Or if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, He can benefit us without these asbab, worldly shapes and configurations. Importance of sunnah. If we learn and implement the sunnah and the pattern of life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will be able to change our life and bring deen into our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will improve our condition in any manner He chooses. And if we try to obtain anything of this world by going against the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will spoil our conditions in any manners He chooses. If we can understand and implement this belief regarding the sunnah, then practicing deen becomes very easy and beloved. But if we have not received this guidance and we feel that the asbab, worldly shape and everything like that is what is driving the success of an individual, then we will have a very difficult time to live in this world. So for us to benefit from hidayah, guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the effort of da'wah and has given us du'as. The du'as are able to strengthen the effort through which we can gain hidayah. Masjid are the platform for deen. The platform for us to obtain guidance and for us to practice deen easily are masjids. And in masjids, it is specially prohibited to discuss worldly affairs as well as to discuss and make concerns for our businesses. The people who make the masjid abad, that's populate the masjid with amal, specific amal, have been given the glad tidings of being mu'min, that's believer. The populating of the masjid never implied that we populate it with any worldly things or populate it with anything from the marketplace. Rather, populating the masjid means creating an environment of talking about the knowledge of ones of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ilm-e ilahi, religious knowledge, and also making the environment of zikr and salat. All these good deeds and amals are considered to be part of populating the masjid. And those who engage in these amal to populate the masjid, they have been declared as mu'min, that's believer. And they have been given the glad tidings that their du'as will be accepted. And they have been given the glad tidings that they will be the means of guidance for other people. So whosoever stand up on this effort with their own life and wealth and resources and make effort with these amal in this ummat of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, roaming continuously from country to country, tolerating patiently and steadfastly all the difficulties and impacts on his means of livelihood. So such people who are doing these particular amal with sacrifice and patience become among the elite workers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows upon them a great gift that their du'as for themselves, for their close ones, and for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the entire humanity become so effective like the du'as of the Anbiya alayhi wasallatu wasallam. The path of effort of da'wat is a very great effort which gives great benefit and honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in general conditions. However, these are some situations, occasions and seasons where the value of this path of effort, the struggle in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes even greater and the reward and benefit are increased immensely. In this era when deen is in decline, making effort in such an era carries much more reward and much more value than making effort in era where people will welcome deen. Fazail of Ramadan and the angels. So one of these occasions is the month of Ramadan. In the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already put in a place a system of guidance to be distributed to people and the shayateen are locked up so that they are not able to take people away from guidance and the angels are generally distributed around the world so that they are able to bring people towards guidance. This ruhaniyat, the spirituality and the grandeur of the angel Jibreel alayhi salam is such that the horse that he rides, the hooves of his horse have such a blessed effect that when this hoof touches the sand, dirt, that sand starts to produce vegetation. So if just the hoof of his horse is so spiritual that it causes vegetation to grow, then imagine how much noor and spirituality is with the angel himself. The angel who bring the wahi, revelations to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has not come into this world for so long since the wahi stopped. But in this month, even this angel comes down to the earth in this month of Ramadan. So in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up the door of Jannah and the damsels of Jannah are decorating your Jannah and the doors of Jahannam are closed in this month. And with a little bit of effort, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month gives a tremendous amount of khair. Amal of Hidayat done in the month of Hidayat. So imagine, if we make this path of effort in such a month in which generally hidayat, guidance is already opened up and distributed around the people and hidayat, guidance is already opened up and means of hidayat, that's guidance, are already infiltrating into the humanity. Can we imagine what value and status the effort in this month, such an effort that contains the hidayat, guidance of the entire mankind at large? If that effort takes place in this month, what kind of value and effect will be there? Already in this month of Ramadan, the attention towards those actions of hidayat are already there. I mean, this a month where the inclination towards those things that will bring hidayat to an individual already there. So just imagine the effort of those amal of hidayat performed in the house of hidayat, like the masjid, and done with the effort of hidayat. The effort of hidayat, that's da'wat. In the month of hidayat, that's Ramadan. In the house of hidayat, that's masjid. Imagine if we make the effort of hidayat in these circumstances, what kind of level and what kind of result from hidayat will come around and will come into existence because of this. Some of the most intense and significant effort and expeditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum ajma'in and some of the most remarkable unseen help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Sahaba happened in this month. Expeditions in the month of Ramadan. For example, the sacrifices and the journey in the expedition of Badr. The revelations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on this and the help that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them in the battle of Badr happened in the month of Ramadan. Also Fatah Makkah, which was the journey and expedition which is the pinnacle of all the expeditions which become the means for the entire tribe of the area surrounding Makkah Mukarramah to come into Islam. Fatah Makkah was also in this month. And in the Mubarak blessed month, making effort of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the effort of hidayat, and then doing it with the proper usul and proper technique, and doing this along with it crying at night and making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the general hidayat of mankind is essential. All you brothers with courage, stand up and make intentions that for long period of time and with as much of expenditure for the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can come up with and as much sacrifice that you can make to go out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and encourage others also to make intentions and prepare them for making effort through chilla 40 days and 4 months in near and far localities alike. How fortunate would it be for us if we initiate and start to bring alive the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the fundamental of Islam, how great would it be if we can start this effort by going for 4 months, starting in this month of Ramadan, and with the intention of going for 40 days and more, how we can make it a common trend to go in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Increase your level in your local jawla, gasht, and also increase the amount of personal zikr and ibadat and dua that you are doing in your personal time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to benefit from striving in this path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and allow us to sparkle with the deen in this world and in the akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast in making effort of deen throughout our life. Banda Muhammad Yusuf, may Allah forgive me. Ameen. End of the letter. The note from Nizamuddin Shura. So this was the letter of Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullahi Alayh that just concluded. Now this is a little bit of addition. A note at the end from the Shura of Markaz Nizamuddin, and it says this. So Hazrat Maulana Yusuf Rahmatullahi Alayh, this above mentioned and above presented letter has given us the importance and has mentioned and outlined the value of establishing Amal in the Masjid in this month of Ramadan. So we are encouraged in our own Masjid Jamaat, Masjidwar Jamaats in our own locality to make targheeb with one another and making intentions to be in itikaf in this month of Ramadan. Itikaf. So this amal of itikaf is joined together individual work, ibadat and dawat. Join them together so that in this through the means of itikaf, so that the masjid remains populated throughout the entire year. However, those of you who have not spent your annual 40 days, then this is going to be the priority that you spend 40 days first. And those who have spent 40 days, then now you make tarteeb and organize and encourage all the rest of the brothers, your brothers and sathis in your masjid for tarteeb of staying in itikaf in the masjid.